train out of the Polaris and installed it into a golf cart. I stretched it out, of course. Mm-hmm. Yes, four-wheel drive. You go on the beach. You're not going to get stuck. If you do, it's your own fault because you shouldn't have been there. You know, in the soft stuff. But this is for a no-drive zone in Volusia County. I have three of these to do right now. This is the first one that was produced. It will be copyrighted. I will be patenting it, and I will be marketing these things. It is solar powered. There's three freezers inside. Well, actually, there's two in there right now. The third one's in the office. It has a controller right here. The inverter powers the freezers. There's an onboard charger, so at night, the sun charges, keeps the freezers going. At night, when there's no sun, it's plugging into a regular wall outlet, and it keeps everything going. The freezers go down to 38 below, and they stay there. I started working for a gentleman over in the Villages, working on golf carts, and it kind of sparked something in me. And about 2.5 years ago, I decided to go on my own and start building golf carts. And I didn't want to do what everybody else did. I wanted to do something different. That's why the Mercedes-Benz is a one-of-a-kind. There's only one in the world like it. It took almost 5 months to carve that out of stone to make a mold of it. Again, with the 28 open wheel roadster, that was a one-of-a-kind. Just something I had in the back of my head I'd like to try and do. Rolls Royce, that was actually made by a company called Elmco back in the 70s and 80s. I found that one down in the Keys and brought it back and restored it to its almost original condition. And it's kind of my toy now.
Yeah.
So, other than that, you know, I love to be different. I love to be creative. And that's basically
Is that a Model T?
That's a T-Bucket, yes. That's in Las Vegas. It's a one-of-a-kind build. I built that with the other company that I was with.